Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great honor to be here in Saatgoed, the root place of Langenzelz. I understood last year when I visited the landfill site together with Graham and Per. And it's an honor to be again at Stockholm because Langenzelz and all the colleagues are very happy. I'm very happy to see that they will transform the ideas to the future. And I will give some ideas now how to do that. And Graham will afterwards tell you about things we spoke at Uppsala in a very small it was a coffee shop, not a drugs shop, but a small coffee shop about how we can translate the waste hierarchy into research hierarchy. And then you have to fill up several points. I mention them afterwards. you see some points I will speak about now, very shortly, the origin and development of waste hierarchy. It was 1979 that I proposed that hierarchy in the Dutch parliament. Then how you can come to more circularity. Of course, the decoupling of economic growth and ecology. Some points about innovation. I gave you also three examples of value creation in several fields to see that that's possible. One of the examples is, of course, the work has done by Langenzelz. And for me, also an important point to avoid the leaks in the system, in a circular system, and make clear choices in some fields. I will show them in a couple of minutes, 10, 15 minutes. How what about the time?
35
over then. For time enough, for instance. You see the following, the order of the waste hierarchy. I started with not with reduction, but with prevention. But you can prevent by reduction, of course, lifetime extension, and so on. You see the different colors and landfill on the last slide. There are some pictures in literature we has transformed the ladder of Lansing, that's the name in the Netherlands, or preference order, in upside down. And that's important because most of the measures have to do with reuse or avoid waste. That's an important point and also a difference with the ideas of Michael Braungart. First, which forces drive me in the 70s to propose that hierarchical system. First, the Club of Rome in 1975, I guess, that report about shortage of materials in the future, very important report indeed. Then in the Netherlands, the notion of stewardship, in Dutch terms, we call it rentmeesterschap, stewardship, guest in your own house, say the Dutch minister at that time against me. It's all the same words for all different words for the same idea. We had the energy crisis 1 and 2 in the 70s. And there was also a very important report of the Minister of Economic Affairs in the Netherlands, Mr. Lubbers, who became later Prime Minister, about selective economical growth. There were two specific, for the Netherlands specific points, the lack of landfill capacity. And there was a very big, on several places, very big soil pollution. because of some landfilling sites, but also because of illegal dumping. And now I have put on the other side the developments between the during this year, from 2010 till now. You see the same points, of course. Not all the same, but some have links with the other. The scarcity of raw materials, sustainability instead of stewardship, climate policy, very important, especially the last 10, 20 years. Circular economy, there is some relation, a very strong relation between the two, of course. I will show you afterwards. Then we have the discussions and ideas about urban mining on several places. We had the problems of marine litter, plastic soup, ocean, the oceans with plastic material in it, the loss of biodiversity, and we have geopolitical issues. Every day, every month, every day. Also, this days, if you look for the struggle between China and United States about rare earth metals and so on. I show you very shortly the text, but then translated in English, of course, of my proposal. That was the official proposal in the Dutch Parliament. And I mention especially the points A, B, and C. A, prevention. B, reuse of raw materials after separation at source, so at home, separating all kinds of things, as plastics, paper, metal, and so on. Then separation afterwards in separation plants. That's below that separation at source. Actually, now at present in the Netherlands, there will be made new installations last week, again, one in Rotterdam, for the third line. And they ask the people to put all things together and separate it afterwards. With a loss of quality. Giving more quantity, but a loss of quality. That's not a good idea. But by only by financial reasons, they choose that that line. so there is some difference between the feelings at that time and now. Then, you of course, the waste to energy. And finally, functional landfilling. So in anti-noise walls and so on. That was at that time my idea in 1979. So I guess it was 40 years ago. in a Dutch report of the Dutch Technology Institute, there was a paragraph about circular concepts. And I was surprised to find my name in that report several years ago. Because in that report, other people, so other researchers, told the readers that the ladder of Lansing, you see that green line on the on that ladder there, over there, they see it as a circular concept. And actually, it is true, because prevention is a part of important part of it. So that's the first circular concept. Afterwards, there are several other ones. Industrial symbiosis, industrial ecology. Of course, cradle to cradle, with the large difference between cradle to cradle from Michael Braungart and me, is that he denies prevention. He tells the people in his reports and his books and so on, if all waste is food, then we can eat and can eat. We can go further with consumentism. And that's not a good idea, because all materials and products need energy to make them. So he has forgotten the energy component. I discussed that point with him in my in other Dutch book, and also in some meetings in Belgium. And afterwards, he agreed with me after several years, but too late. he is now not any longer leading in this field. Still leading, and that's good. I forget. Uh, I f- forget one point. The importance of cradle to cradle is the point of the eco-design. That's for the first time that he put that on a clear way. So that's the profit of that system. And then the last one on the right side, the green, that's the Ellen MacArthur Foundation with the ideas about circular economy. And it's still a leading foundation in the discussions all over the world. So and that's a very good reports and so on. On the left side, you see the legislation. The first, the brown, is the Club of Rome, this is before the hierarchy. And then we have several regulation mechanisms in the Netherlands and in Europe. The last one is from 2018, the new European Waste Directive with that waste hierarchy in it. And again, the first legislation in the Netherlands was in 1993. And the first legislation of around waste hierarchy in the European Waste Directive in 2008. That was the reason for me to write a book about it. Other people asked me to write a book. It's a Dutch book, has appeared in 2010. And afterwards, other people asked me to make an English book because the waste hierarchy has spread about all other countries, and to understand the history and also the future, I have written this book or this one. it's too heavy to send, so I have to make an e-book of it. But first, I have to sell the books which has been left. So it's going very fast and good. So. But I will do that and make also an e-book of it, with, of course, additions. For instance, the point which we discussed in Uppsala about time, place and function. That's a nice point to add in the next edition. And perhaps also we can put the name of Graham on that, if the ideas about how to come to the research hierarchy will come true. Now I have two slides to show you what we have to link to do to come from the waste hierarchy to the research hierarchy. We have to maintain the point of reduction, the prevention, lifetime extension, and all kinds of things to reduce the amount of waste. That's important because the relation till climate policy. But then, on every level, you can make a change in a good sense by going to the new material, reuse, and to recycling. And the aim has to be to reuse a material. So if you tell the people, oh, we have 60% recycling, that's nice, but it's not enough. You have to show that you use the materials in new products or the same products, but anyhow in products and not only recycling. Recycling alone is not enough. So that's the meaning of this figures. you have to go circular in all kinds of things, and you have to look for a very clear chain management. And because we're talking about it's all about chains, you have to cooperate with all parties working in the chain. That's also a big challenge because every party has its own interests, of course. of course, landfilling is no longer the point. That's therefore the red cross. Unless you use temporary landfilling to work on a later moment, and that's the point of time, to new materials from it. Incineration is possible, but not in all places, so I will show it later on. Here you see the challenges if you go to that mechanism which I showed you already on the other figure. First, design for recycling. That's from the linear system, you have to put that in the circular system. That's one important point. And on the other side, landfilling disposals, old landfilling sites, you can try to reuse and you come into the circle. The other ones are important to explain to the people the point, for instance, of consumer awareness is playing a role in marketing, but also in consumption. Do we need all consumption? Of can we take some more time with products? Some people in the during a presentation in the Netherlands, Rotterdam, somebody in the audience asked me, why do we too little on reuse of products? So and then I asked the people. So I ask you a question. Do you have all a mobile and a smartphone? All people say yes. And then I ask them, and which is less than 1 year old? Most less than 1 year old. So they changed too many times their smartphone because new software, new products, new possibilities. I've now decided to use my smartphone as long as possible, 4 years, 5 years, 6 years. That makes a big difference. That's one of the points. So marketing and consumption. Then chain management and the relation to climate policy are important for all steps. And that's the reason that I put that circle in the middle of the whole chains. So we have to look for the relation to climate policy. Some studies have learned that about you can gain between 20 and 40% reduction related to climate policy, if you of CO2, of course, if you choose for circularity. I have put another point, on this slide, the risk, the global risk we meet every day, of course, the risk of prosperity growth, that's a good thing, especially in less developed countries, of course, but if you have bigger prosperity and bigger population growth, then it's less easy to make a reduction in what people want. So there is the decreasing raw material shortage. The reuse will decrease if people like consumerism. And of course, there is the political instability. This report is from 3 years ago. So I guess that now, if you look at this moment, at that point, political instability, it will be more than 26% because of the struggle between China and the United States about all kind of things. So if you look to these figures, then you see the risks are not only technological, but also physical, economical, social, and geopolitical. We have to decouple consumerism and economic activities from resource use, and especially also if we want to have less environmental impact, then we have to bridge these gaps. And so for me is that a very important issue because governments will not take the lead, so private companies have to take the lead, but they have to earn the money. So that's a very difficult point. But anyhow, we have to bridge these gaps. I learned last year when I was at a symposium in Stockholm from the CIFRA report. This figure comes from the CIFRA report that you can reuse the emissions of CO2 with 56% in 2050 in some fields, in more fields, but that are very important ones, in steel, plastics, aluminium, and cement. And that's because you need much energy to produce it. So if you reuse these materials, you can make a big change. And the same is true for the ideas to do that. It's too much to to take too much time to explain them all, but car sharing is, for instance, a point on the left side, and you see other remanufacturing, of course, reuse of plastics, reuse of copper. And in the material sector, if you make buildings and make material passports of all kinds of things which are in the building, then you make easier to reuse that material. So that's important for concrete. Of course, aluminium is in it, plastic in it, and so on. Now I show you some points. All those points are explained, of course, in my book in more detail. But now to give you an overview. You have to create loops and close loops on all fields and on various levels, the low level, regional level, but also on global level. That's a big design. New technologies, value creation, of course. And also important is shared responsibility. And that's important for the governments, that they tell the people and the private companies, we have to do it together. So coupling of legislation to what the possibilities to the possibilities of private private companies. I think that private companies have to take the lead, and some do it, but there are a couple of companies which earn money without looking for the possibilities in the future. decoupling, I have told you already. And the point of the business models, that is, I guess that Graham will talk about that also, but that's for me a difficult point because I'm not active in retail management, but in the Netherlands we have a very big informal investor with many money. And he has bought a year ago our biggest retail company with 600 shops. And he asked me, I want to have more sustainable materials in my shops and so. Can you come to me and explain how to do that? So I have visited him and brought some simple ideas to him. So I'm Marcel Boekhoorn is his name. But I guess that also the retailers have big chances to do more on sustainability. And anyhow, HEMA is the name of that retail chain. That is also active in France, in Belgium, and so on. Will earn money on the long run of it if they do the good job. But the market imperfections is indeed a very difficult point. Now, of course, we need renewable energy to a larger extent than we have at present. Then the special dilemmas. Here only a short overview. I will explain some of them, the circular dilemmas, and also the leakages in the system in the next slide. And though you see it on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 repairing leaks in circular economy. I told you already that we have to look for different fields, all fields. I make an easy slide to see the largest possibilities, of course, in paper and plastics, in salts, nitration, phosphate, and carbonate, you can, if you choose for sequestration of CO2 from power stations, then you can make new building materials. It's still not on a large scale, but it will be possible. So you see at the metals, of course, glass, several fields. And then you have to look for how we can improve the value of the materials, the secondary and tertiary materials. And you see here the first idea about time, function, and place, which we discussed last year in that, not drugs, coffee shop in Uppsala. There was some time left, actually, so we between two things, so that's was nice. Now I have three examples of value creation. Here, the first one is from waste for energy plants. In the Netherlands, we have several which do in Rotterdam and in Amsterdam now, and is a new one since a couple of years. Rotterdam of EVR, it's making heat, steam, and electricity energy, but also building materials, glass, and metals are coming from the bottom ash. So that's a nice point that you can make more value from waste. And if you do looking for the good way, then you become more circular and come from waste to circular hierarchy. The second one is from Rangen cells, the extraction of cells from fly ash and from mining waste, with another effect that you can have if you have the good technology, then you can also find rare earth metals in that ash and in that mining waste and in the ash, especially the ash, is it there? So that will be important if the shortage and of rare earth metals will increase. The third example is in from the bio mass sphere, bio-based economy. There you see the choice you have to make. Not to all places, but you can make the choice for high value or high volume from the same material. So that will be depend on the place, the location, and also the time. If you choose for energy from biofuels as main from all your material, of you choose for high value pharmaceuticals. If they are important for the health system, then you have to choose the first one, this of course. But that's a couple of examples in the circular system. Now, some words about the dilemmas, the choices. That's also not a difficult slide, but difficult choices you can make, governments have to make, or companies or consumers. The first one is, do we look for steering by the government and government control, or producer responsibility? Of course, the trust is in the mid-side, but it depends on the material, on the products and so on, if it is on the left or on the right side. And there are some countries where the government control is very heavy. China, of course, but also Eastern Germany before the wall, the time of the wall, plain economics. So that's fun. Then the second line, do we choose for fiscal measures or do we choose for a free market? Fiscal measures that by fiscal ways, government gives some steering to the for instance, the the production of electric cars, but other country. Sometimes the government do not the good choice. For instance, if you look for the difference between a lease society and right on ownership of how do you call it, a product service, product as a service, then it's not good to make higher value-added tax. Still in the Netherlands, the Dutch government is straight for secularity, but makes the value-added tax on services higher. That's not a good direction, of course. So you see that that's a big contradiction. Now, the other things, do we choose for national policy or international rules? I choose for international rules, of course, the broader scope, value, volume, you have already. Then the leakages in the system. One of the leakages is the market failure, point four. I located some places, the most important ones, this nine. Perhaps are more, lacking technology, global barriers, consumer behavior, all kinds of things we have to overrule, to overcome, to go to more security. One of the main issues there is how can we internalization of costs and also non-material costs in a fixed amount of money or something like that. That's not easy because it's not so easy to translate social effects, work for instance, in money. But anyhow, we have to look for possibilities. Of course, there are several innovation issues. And if you go to more secularity, I told already about the product design, the processing of the materials. Logistics is important, also reverse logistics. Energy, the immobilization technology for dangerous materials. Can we immobilize such way that we can use that material as building material, the chain management and the value certification. And perhaps there is some are possibilities in the new systems of blockchain technology. So all those points I have written about, and I've the last years learned also new points, so not all what I have said can you find in my book, but a lot of the issues still. To make it easy readable for people who have not enough time, I have made a summary, and also in that summary made a relation to the global development goals, the sustainable development goals from the United Nations. not all of them as a direct relation, but you see in the first row the key issue, then something like a proposal or a sentence, and all those points have been worked out, of course, in my book. So that's also on the level of my comments. These are critical comments. For instance, the first one is important. Sometimes you see that, especially governments, have some problems with the expectations. So they tell the people in 2030 we will be waste-free, 100% waste-free. That's not possible. So then you have not to tell that kind of things. And on the lowest rung, you see that I plead for lower emphasis on marketing. Marketing is important, of course, but you have to give people the good information. There is an outlook chapter also. If we go to security, then we will have more work, new technologies, spin-off, and so on. Social innovation, very important. In line with what Pope Franciscus has told people in his encyclical Laudato Si, the binding between justice and sustainability, and that's very important if you come in countries where in less developed countries. Happily, last year I have to speak in South Africa, in Lebanon. And there I meet the people who from less developed countries, also saw the landfilling sites, burning sites, especially in Lebanon. And then you see the big difference between our countries in Europe and the people in Africa and Asia and so on. So that's that's the reason that I have a plea for social innovation and for justice. The last slide, I think some recommendations. You have to read the book, but I have given you an impression about the connection between all kinds of things in a less or more holistic system. That's my conclusion, and I thank you for your attention.
So, in 2018, please like last extend a little bit just. In 2018, this book was then also given a global award. So it's really proven that this is the Bible. And you see, it's pretty thick. Anyhow, if you're interested, we have a couple of copies that you can borrow from us later on. Otherwise, please, so he will make an e-book. So order them instead. Anyhow, I would say that the last year when we had the discussions about development, I've been so impressed over your interest to really deep dive and understand what will the future will look like. And I talked with my mother-in-law. She is by herself, she's 85 years old. And she is really also at the same energy that you has. And I asked her, to be honest, you can't be 85, you must be 30. Yes, Per, you're correct. In my head, I'm 30. And exactly what we see from you also. Yeah. So we hope that you will stay with us and continue to develop the methods going forward. Again, a big hand.